Holy Ghost is on the move.
Yeah, Firebirds had a lot of momentum.
Right from the jump for the Firebirds, who look really good.
The coaches versus Cantor right here at Holy Ghost Prep. And tonight's VIWR game featuring Pottstown High School and Holy Ghost Prep. Introducing tonight's starting lineups. Firstly, the Trojans of Pottstown High School. Number two, Julian Beasley. Number four, Ty Cleary Moore. Number five, Abdul Jackson. Number 23, Sandy Jackson. Number 0, Jarrell Young. Head coach of the Trojans is Kenneth Ivory. And now starting on for the Firebirds of Colin O'Sullivan. Going guard of Mike Benson, number 3, Mike Tomasetti. And for the 6-4 senior, number 4, Brendan Bowen. And for the 6-2 senior, number 14, Seamus McDermott. And for the 6-2 sophomore, number 22, Varella. Number 4, a 6-3 senior, number 25, Ian Hendrix. Head coach of the Firebirds is Carelli.
All right. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Chapman Arena in the Firebirds Fieldhouse at Holy Ghost Prep for episode number 2 of the Holy Ghost Prep Firebirds Varsity Basketball Home Season. I'm Caden Stewart.
I'm Jack Dobbins.
And we'll have the call for you live for these full 32 action-packed minutes. As opening tip-off, there's a Brendan Boutillier, and he knocks it right to the Trojans of Pottstown. It was Julian Beasley who got the ball to start. Now back to Abdul Jackson. Jackson passes back out to the top of the key to Ty Elliott Moore. Elliott Moore to Sadiq Jackson. Jackson back to the other Jackson of Abdul Jackson. Now lofts back up. It's blocked, and the Firebirds get a good defensive play to start off. Here comes Tomasetti. Comes across the line.
I mean, Tomasetti's been that point guard so far this season. He's been putting up his best numbers of his career, starting off at the varsity level as a senior. He's just doing his job.
Yeah. He's doing the work. Underhand pass, and it's a foul for Holy Ghost Prep, and they'll go to the line to shoot two. Adrien Varella, I got his name right this time.
Finally.
Yeah, scored 23 points, a sophomore in the last game, and was the MVP of the game in the Firebirds home opener earlier this week.
If Adrien starts off hot this game, I can definitely see the he's a sophomore chant coming back.
So Seamus McDermott rattles his first foul shot home. In 40 seconds into regulation, we have our first point. Courtesy of a Seamus McDermott foul shot, he has one more. McDermott's second is up and no good. It's rebounded by Pottstown, so the score stands at 1-0 Holy Ghost. Abdul Jackson going out to the other Jackson, Sadiq Jackson. There's another Jackson, Jameer Jackson. There's a lot of Jacksons on this Pottstown Trojans team. As Ty Elliott Moore with the ball. Elliott Moore pivots, goes to the side, open for three, and it's no good. That was Julian Beasley who took the three. It's rebounded by the Firebirds. Here comes McDermott. McDermott got to the side of Mark Tomasetti. Tomasetti from the far side. Goes across to Boutillier. Boutillier to McDermott. McDermott back to Boutillier, and it's too far. Boutillier can't hang on.
This better not be where the turnover issue starts, because that could cost Holy Ghost big time.
Yeah, they had a turnover issue earlier on the JV game, and a lot last week in both the JV and varsity games. Here comes Pottstown, charging on in. That was Jackson, who couldn't get it to fall. It was Abdul Jackson, to specify. Tomasetti is threading the needle pass into the paint, and it's good. Ian Hendrix knocks it in for two. Comes in every single day at 6 a.m. to get working on jump shots, and still maintains a 4.25 GPA. Absolutely all-around stud guy at HGP. And he now throws it back out to Mark Tomasetti after the drive for Pottstown comes up empty. Tomasetti throws it in, it's intercepted. Here comes Pottstown up across half court, charging in, and a charging foul against Pottstown.
Wow.
Oh, and they call it against Tomasetti. They call a blocking foul against Mark Tomasetti.
I'm stunned that was a blocking foul. The shoulder was lowered. That's crazy.
Yeah, it could have gone either way.
Probably.
Yeah, definitely a questionable call, no matter how you call it. So, Pottstown will inbound. Abdul Jackson will be the inbounder. And both teams go out splitting at the size. Jackson out to the corner to tie Elliott Moore. Elliott Moore with an assist, it's good. And the first points of the game come from Sadiq Jackson in a long-range triple. As 3-3, 5:40 to go in the first quarter.
That was a really deep three ball, and quite honestly, it was a perfecto.
Yeah. Thomas A. dumps up Brendan Boutillier, the senior. Boutillier back at the top. It's Adrien Varella. It's a three, and it's good. The sophomore. The sophomore heating up, and Adrien Varella is 6-3, Firebirds. Back up to the top, another three. It's in and out.
Oh.
And rebounded by Brendan Boutillier in the paint. Boutillier out to McDermott. McDermott out to the far side to Hendrix. Hendrix pivots, and he's fouled. Or travel, never mind.
Wow. What were you saying about Hendrix earlier?
He comes to school every day at 6 a.m.
Are you serious?
Jump shots before class.
No way.
He still has a 4.25 GPA.
That's wild. I never even knew that. That's wild.
That's incredible. That's absolutely incredible how you can do that. Here's Pottstown, a quick turnover. That was Ty Elliott Moore who gave it away to Seamus McDermott. McDermott, Hendrix, to Boutillier, and Boutillier touched it last. Or never mind, it was off a Pottstown defenseman, either Rasheen Bostic or Sadiq Jackson. No matter who it was, it saves Firebird ball as McDermott inbounds it right into Mark Tomasetti. Tomasetti has a hole. Tomasetti over it up, head in and out. Here comes Pottstown, coming across half court again to the three-point line, lays up for two, and it's a foul called against HGP. That was Abdul Jackson who came in, and he'll go to the line to shoot two. And Varella, who just hit the big-time three for the Firebirds, called for the foul.
I don't believe he had one in the Ben Salem game.
Did he? He wasn't at the Ben Salem game.
Yeah, so I don't remember.
I didn't hear anything about a foul, but 23 points.
You weren't at the game?
No. The last game.
The Ben Salem game?
Oh, wait, that was the...
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was another game in between now and then.
No, that was the last home game.
Oh, so he scored 23 points in that game. That was
No. He scored 23 points away.
That's what I'm telling you, the away game.
No, I'm talking about in the game we broadcasted.
Well, yeah, never mind. The two foul shots both go down. Pottstown cuts the lead down to one at 6-5. Tommy said he has to McDermott. McDermott, it's a long three, it's good! The third three of the game hit by either team, the second by the Firebirds, just 9-5.
That's what I said.
Here's Mark Tomasetti. Tomasetti goes back and talks to McDermott. McDermott. Back out across to Tomasetti. Tomasetti, top of the key. Tomasetti spinning in and out. Varella to the corner. It's Hendrix. It's a three. It's no good. And was that a foul called against Boutillier? No, it was not. However, it was. So Boutillier called for the foul. Pottstown takes over. Not sure what the foul was, but Boutillier called on it. Here is Abdul Jackson. Jackson taking it up across half court near the three-point line. They cut back and forth. Now it's a three on the way, and that bounced off the bounce to the base of the backboard.
Great rebound by Varella.
Yeah, Ty Elliott and Moore took the three. Varella with the rebound, throws it, it's 9-1! Ian Hendrix for the and-one attempt.
The definition of a student athlete with a perfect play drawn out.
As now 11-5, Hendrix goes to the line to shoot one, trying to complete the three-point play. That's the second foul of the game for Pottstown, the fifth overall for either team. So Beasley subs on for Sadiq Jackson. For Pottstown. Hendrix will be at the foul line. He gets the one bounce pass from the ref. Double dribbles twice and lost it towards the net, and it's good. Hendrix knocks down the foul shot. It's 12-5 Firebirds.
A 7-point lead can be big, especially in the first quarter.
Yeah.
We're only 4 minutes and 15 seconds in, and there's already been 17 power points scored.
So Colin Lucas subs on for Ian Hendrix for the Firebirds. So a new set of fresh legs on. Pottstown needs to get across the half court. They will. And now Ty Elliott Moore from the top. Elliott Moore slicing through. It's good. Ty Elliott Moore, a beautiful layup inside from the paint. And it's now 12-7 Firebirds. Varella with the ball. Varella one leg sleeve, the other Baron. Varella dumps it off. And the three-pointer from McDermott was up and no good. The Firebirds in their home white and reds. Pottstown their away blue and whites. And now there's a three. It's up and it's good.
Wow.
A high arcing, high hanging three by Jarrell Young. And Pottstown has come climbing right back into it. It's now 12-10. And Varella fouled at half court. And Adrien Varella goes to the sideline to inbound. So it's Varella, Boutillier, and it's Tomasetti who gets the ball. The other man on the court are Colin Lucas. And what appears to be Seamus McDermott. It's Tomasetti with the ball and gives it to Brendan Boutillier. Boutillier back to Tomasetti. Tomasetti, a stutter step. Looking to move in. Tomasetti. I got one match to Lucas, and that's a foul. Colin Lucas provided the brilliant feed to Brendan Boutillier under the hoop, and Boutillier was fouled before he got the shot off. Two 2:32 to play in the first quarter. The Firebirds will inbound from underneath their own net. It's Seamus McDermott. Home inbounds to Boutillier. Boutillier pulls off a reset. Varella pump fakes the pass. Varella, and it's bobbled. Rebound by Boutillier. Boutillier back up to the top. Colin Lucas. Lucas gets stripped away. Here comes Pottstown from the 3-point line into the paint, and it's blocked. And now the Firebirds are going to take it away. Thumbs up in the air, out of bounds. A great defensive stand by Holy Ghost. But we'll stay with Pottstown, but a prevention of at least 2 points. And Noah McDermott comes on for the first time today for Holy Ghost. And he comes on in place of Mark Tomasetti, who comes over to get a drink immediately. McDermott now man-to-man coverage with Abdul Jackson's inbound, and it's blocked. McDermott blocks it, and the ball goes to Holy Ghost.
Massive defensive play right there on the inbound. That will be crucial as it gives Ghost the ball with the remaining lead.
And Seamus McDermott, a brilliant block on the inbound. The score stays at 12-10. Holy Ghost.
Do that, I dare you. And hit.
Well, here's Varella coming across half court. Brought himself to Noah McDermott, getting his name called for the first time today after a substitution. Varella almost lost it. Thumbs up to McDermott. McDermott back up to the top. Colin Lucas wide open at the top is McDermott again. This time it's Seamus. Seamus underhand. Colin Lucas for two.
Wow.
A brilliant tic-tac pass to Colin Lucas for two. And it's 14-10 Firebirds.
Great ball movement right there. I mean, that's going to be crucial for Ghost. The chemistry between this team of getting the ball to one another is insane.
And now Elliot Moore with the feed to Rashid Bostic, and Bostic is blocked. Adrien Varella.
He got it right again.
Yeah, I know. I'm on fire. Adrien Varella dumps it off. It's Noah McDermott. McDermott. Looks for Boutillier. Couldn't find him. And goes out to Seamus McDermott. James McDermott back to Noah McDermott. Noah McDermott with the ball. He goes back to the ladder McDermott and throws up and it's no good. Rebounded right in front by Colin Lucas. Lucas to Boutillier. Boutillier for two. It bounces off the front of the rim and in and out. Noah McDermott couldn't get the rebound. Now here is Pottstown. The Trojans looking to come back into it. They had a 5-point run before the timeout. Now they're down two since then. An up and no good. It was a layup from Abdul Jackson that may have been tipped before it got to the net. And now jump ball is loose, picked up by Pottstown, lofted up in the air, and stolen by McDermott, and out of bounds off HGP. But another great defensive play by Seamus McDermott. He has had a lot of action early on. Varella subs off for Mark Tomasetti. Now here is the inbounds. It's Jarrell Young who has the 3-pointer earlier. And he's blocked towards the net and a foul called. Both sides were on completely different sides of that foul call. And it's called against HGP. So Jarrell Young will go to the line to shoot two. And calls from the student section go answer and the first foul shot is missed. Will we have our first Brickin for Chicken, TM, of the game?
Potentially.
Jarrell Young made the second.
We got to get the Chef Jorge sponsorship.
That'd be nice, though. Colin Lucas gets the gets the inbounds. Lucas umps it off.
Every time they miss 5+ free throws, it's free chicken and waffles for breakfast.
I love that.
Dumps it off. We should pitch it to him.
We should. Tomasetti back across to Lucas. Lucas back to Seamus McDermott. Both McDermott's on the floor. It's Seamus with the ball. Seamus has a wide open Tomasetti. He's going to get it. Tomasetti, 15 seconds to go in the first. Tomasetti threw his legs twice. Back out. Boutillier. Back on top, Seamus McDermott for three is no good. Rebound by Pottstown, 2 seconds. They need a shot. Rebound Boutillier for three. No good. Brendan Boutillier stole it away from a Pottstown Cougar, which appeared to have been Bostic. Had an open three at the buzzer and just couldn't get it. So 14-11, Holy Ghost Prep on top after 8 minutes. Eight down, 24 to go. Insane. All right. Adrien Varella takes the ball up across half court, across the Firebird emblem. Varella dumps it off. And now it's Dasani to McNeely, getting his name called for the first time today. McNeely to McDermott. McDermott has Dasani open at the top, and it's stripped away, but it rebounded, or picked back up by McNeely. McNeely slicing in. McNeely up and over. It's no good. And Colin Lucas jumped too early for the rebound, and now Pottstown takes it up with the Trojans. Abdul Jackson. Jackson, Sutter steps back up to the top with Julian Beasley. Beasley throws it to the corner. Sadiq Jackson, and the step out he did.
Insane defense by Dasani McNeely Bronson right there. That was insane.
Dasani keeping the defense on point, and more great action from the Firebird side. McNeely, a 6'2 senior, being able to keep the Pottstown Trojans in check. And now Varella with a spin move underneath. Varella dumps it off. It's Tomasetti to Colin Lucas for three. Colin Lucas with a big time triple. It's 17-11 Firebirds. It's 6:54 to go in the second.
Ball so hard, Colin. What a shot that was.
Jarrell Young dumps it off. Ty Elliott Moore. Elliott Moore dumps up to Sadiq Jackson. Jackson for two, couldn't get it. Rebounds and foul against the Firebirds.
Oh, Ruger.
Sheen Bostic, who goes to the line for Pottstown. So Dasani McNeely called for the foul. His first foul.
Sheen Bostic at the line for the Trojans. Shoots two.
Bostic looking to cut the lead down to four, and the first one's not close. Student section doing their job. Pottstown now 1-for-3 on foul shots on the day. Our second opportunity for a Brickin' for Chicken promotion.
On Monday, I'm pitching that to Chef.
Bostic missed it.
And it worked.
And everyone gets chicken.
Let's go. Yay. Chef Jorge, you better put up your end.
So here's Noah McDermott. McDermott and Varella almost had it. It's a ball. Rebound by McNeely. Dasani throws it up. It's tipped. Recovered by the Firebirds. Tomasetti throws it across. Open. Sutter step. Colin Lucas couldn't get it to fall. Rebound in for Pottstown. Ty Elliott Moore coming across half court. Elliott Moore from the written emblem. It's a three. It's no good. Here is Noah McDermott. And McDermott will be fouled. Hi, Elliott Moore called for the foul on Pottstown. Adrien Varella will inbound. Pass right back to Noah McDermott. McDermott back up to Varella. Varella inching his way up. Now finds open Tomasetti. Gives it right back. Give and go. Varella! And it spins out. Rebound. Jump ball. And the ball belongs to Pottstown. Pottstown will have the ball in the inbound underneath their own net. It's Jarrell Young who will do so. And Young will have options. But he goes to Abdul Jackson. Jackson, Abdul and Zadik Jackson. They both were in the same vicinity. Abdul takes a shot now. Abdul Jackson road line to shoot two for Pottstown. Rasheem Bostic last went to the line, shot two, missed two. The Firebird fan section has been incredible. 1 for 4 in the day. Can they do it again? Is this time it's good? Abdul Jackson makes his first. It's 17-12 Firebirds. Jackson misses his second, and neither team has gone 2 for 2. I'm sorry, one. Seamus McDermott went 2 for 2 on foul shots earlier for the Firebirds. But besides that, no team has gone 2 for 2 on foul shots. Varella tried to thread the needle pass. Says it was tipped, but it apparently was not. So Pottstown will have the ball. Jarrell Young will inbound. Abdul Jackson, it looks like the receiver. Jackson gets the ball, and Jackson takes up across half court. Jackson, stutter step, dumps it off. Here's a three, it's a long one, and it's just barely off the rim. Julian Beasley took the three, it's rebounded by Hendrix. Hendrix from the far side, cuts back to the center of Tomasetti. Tomasetti splits the defenders. Tomasetti out to the side. It's a three. For Hart, it goes. Prep, it's good! Colin Lucas heating up his 8th point of the game. It's 20-12 Firebirds. And it's stolen away! Firebird ball! What a great defensive play again by Colin Lucas, who is the man of the first half. He strips the ball right away from Julian Beasley, and the Firebird benches hyped up as well as they should be. 20-12, Holy Ghost prep on top. 5 minutes and 2 seconds to go in the half. And can the Firebirds hold on to this lead?
Here comes
Holy Ghost starts with the ball with Adrien Varella. I'll go back to you, Jack.
Varella driving up mid-key over to the left of Hendrix. Dasani on a pick. Hendrix gets knocked away left side.
So it's Ty Elliott Moore for Pottstown knocked the ball away from Ian Hendrix. Hendrix had out to a hot start, has kind of cooled down since then, hasn't on the floor much either. Colin Lucas, who has been the man of the hour, inbounds, and it's a missed layup.
No.
That was Hendrix, who was wide open to the golden opportunity and couldn't convert. And now stripped away, Dasani McNeely with a steal.
Come on, Dasani.
McNeely avoids the foul. Dumps off Lucas, back to Varella. Varella splits the defenders, up and foul.
Big play. I mean, that may have been a little travel in there, but...
Maybe. But hey. Unless it was not called, Ian Hendrix was line to shoot two in the Holy Ghost.
Then again, about the comment earlier, Hendrix was benched pretty much the second half of the first quarter, so not much face to that production there.
But Hendrix with a chance to make up for it. Missed the open layup a moment ago, misses the first foul shot here. Both teams with a slight adjustment. McNeely comes up near the top of the bench. Or so, near the top of the broadcast booth. Hendrix, his second foul shot, and he misses them both. Here is Pottstown. I talked to Coach Jack Krause, or assistant Coach Jack Krause, in between games this week. And throws it back to the top. It's up, and it's no good. There's a three-pointer from Jarrell Young, who completely disagrees with the call. But I talked to Coach Krause earlier. He said foul shots were a big issue in the last game. Did not mention any names, but multiple players went 0 for 2 at the line in their opportunities, and the Firebirds, who lost by 4, have something to work on. Inbound to Varella. Varella pulling the far side. And he cuts in and he's fouled. So the Firebirds will go to the line and shoot two, specifically Adrien Varella will. Or maybe not. It will not go to the line, but the foul is indeed on Julian Beasley of Pottstown, and Beasley being corrected by his coaches. If you complete, if you disagree with the call. Now Tomasetti trying to avoid the over and back, and he will. Tomasetti winds up and the pass is intercepted. Ball sit down, and that was a bad pass, and it goes into the lobby of the Chapman Arena.
That ball almost went into the locker room.
Yeah. It was Deke Jackson who threw the pass all the way down intended for the other Jackson, Abdul Jackson, one of three Jacksons on this team. So here's McDermott, inbounds to Varella. Varella up along the far side. Varella, and he lost it. It was off. And Abdul Jackson called for the second foul of this young game for him. So Varella goes to the line to shoot two. So 1-1 for Varella. 4:07 to go in the half. 20-12, HGP on top. Varella's first one is up and good. And he'll shoot another. Varella dribbles it once. Dribbles it twice. And shoots. And it's in and out. And now Pottstown takes over. So here is the Trojans cutting in and out, and the shot went in and out, and a foul, or no foul called, almost a foul called against Seamus McDermott. A late three by Ty Elliott Moore will not count, and the Firebirds will inbound. The Firebirds inbound is Seamus McDermott. Tomasetti subs off Brendan Boutillier. McDermott inbounds to Varella. Varella inching his way up. Thunder steps. Varella trying to slice through. Boutillier back up to the top. Going around the horn with it. That's Gavin McLaughlin. McLaughlin wide open. Colin. And that was Colin Lucas who had a wide open three. Couldn't connect. And now a slice through. There was a foul called. It appeared.
Lucas,
yeah, it's Lucas called for the foul on the Firebird. Sadiq Jackson goes to the line.
One and one
attempt for Jackson. And it is a made foul shot to start. 21-13, Holy Ghost Prep. Both teams have 7 fouls this first half. And the second foul shot is up and good. So Sadiq Jackson goes 2-for-2 at the line. Hendrix subs back on for the Firebirds to take out Colin Lucas, the forward. Hendrix can play guard and forward. It appears he'll come on to be forward for the moment. Adrien Varella up across half court. Varella underneath. Boutillier back on top to McDermott. McDermott. Underhand. Varella. Thread the needle inside, and the and one attempt to be missed. That was Ian Hendricks, who took the two, couldn't find it, but it'll go to the line to shoot two.
Coach Chapman doesn't seem too happy about that missed layup.
Yeah. So Rasheen Bostic called for the foul. Hendricks missed the foul shot earlier, missed two, and misses his third in a row. Hendrix, one more attempt. It's up, and it's good. So Hendrix goes 1-for-2 at the line, getting his first points in a while. It's 22-14. There comes Pottstown up on the far side. Did he step out? He may have, but it was ruled Pottstown ball before he did. Ty Elliott Moore was the Pottstown Trojan. And Brendan Boutillier called for his second foul of the game. And now both teams up at 8.
1-1.
And here comes the ghost celebrity himself, Colin Todd, on in the foul rectangle.
Yeah, Todd heated up late in his game on the Thursday night game against Bensalem. And the first foul shot goes to Ty Elliott Moore, shooting 1-1. And this will be his second on the way.
Hey, Caden, I don't know if you've seen it, but there's a ghost viral Instagram page. It's called Colin Todd Fan Page, and it is maybe the funniest ghost-related page on Instagram. It is incredible, quite honestly.
I have not seen it, but we'll go look after this broadcast.
I'll send it to you afterward. It's so funny.
So Varella comes up along the far side. Varella slices the defenders, and he goes down hard. Pottstown takes over. It's a 4-on-4, and Pottstown pulls off, looking for help, and it's turned over. It was Ty Elliott Moore looking for some help. Comes off to McDermott. McDermott to Varella. Varella can't make the two. It's rebounded by Pottstown in the paint. Out of bounds, and the ball belongs to Pottstown.
It looked like Varella was uncomfortable after sliding about maybe 10 feet on the ground after being pushed. Yeah. That did not look good. And he's like kind of...
slightly limping.
He's limping off the court.
He appears to be okay. It's Rasheen Bostic. Rasheen Bostic who collided with Varella. And now Pottstown takes up across half court. It's Ty Elliott Moore. It's stolen away by Tomasetti. Mark Tomasetti. Up and over, and he missed it. Rebounds. McDermott couldn't get it to fall. Underhand back up, and almost intercepted by Hendrix. Here comes Pottstown. Cut back. Dump ball. They're open for three. Didn't take it. Now they will. It's a long three. It's no good. Sadiq Jackson on the way from three. And now the Firebirds will take over. Rasheen Bostic went down for Pottstown. A possession is awarded to the Firebirds in this 6-point 22-16 game. Mark Tomasetti up along the far side. Tomasetti pivots. Inches his way across half court. Goes to Hendrix. Hendrix across Tomasetti. Tomasetti at the top of the key. Tomasetti back to Hendrix. Hendrix charges in.
That's McLaughlin.
That was who?
McLaughlin.
That was McLaughlin, sorry. McLaughlin turns it over. Here comes Pottstown, splitting the defenders, and he missed it.
Good block by Tomasetti.
Yeah, but that was Zeke Jackson, who was splitting the defenders, couldn't find the layup, and Ty Elliott Moore picks up where he left off, 22-18. Now McDermott dumps it off. Colin Todd. Todd, and he lost it. Ball belongs to Pottstown. Colin Todd got the ball knocked away from him as he was trying to find a way in. Now with a minute 40 to go, it's a 22-18 Holy Ghost Prep lead, and a timeout is called. But as I said a moment ago, 1 minute and 40 seconds to go in this second period, second half. Here is Pottstown up across half court, going back and forth with it. It's Ty Elliott Moore. Moore holds on to it for the moment. Again, for the pass to Sadiq Jackson. Jackson trying to recover his own loss, and he picks it up. Jackson, stutter step, back out to the top. Terrell Young. Young, back to Elliott Moore. Elliott Moore lost it up, and he can't finish. Here comes HGP. It's Hendrix. Hendrix. Stutter step. Finds McDermott. McDermott to Varella. Varella has 3 points earlier. Thumps off. Back to Varella. Varella thumps off again. Open for three, and it's no good.
McLaughlin barely missed it off the back edge of the rim.
Yeah, McLaughlin very close to it. Couldn't find it. And now Julian Beasley dumps it off for three. It's no good. Beasley with a pass. And it's out of bounds on Pottstown. Jarrell Young exclaiming disappointment again.
Exactly 45 seconds of the play before halftime. Ghost up by four.
And now Tomasetti takes up across half court. Tomasetti between the legs with it. Firebird's going to run out the clock if they want to. Tomasetti back out to Varella. That's Adrien Varella. I got his name right today. I just said his name Aiden about 1,000 times on Thursday night.
I don't think you've gotten it wrong yet today.
I have not. Adrien Varella with the ball. Varella to the half court. Sutter stepping. The Firebirds look like they're trying to take the last shot. Varella dumps it off. Tomasetti. Tomasetti trying to slice in. And he's blocked. Ball was out of bounds. And it's off of Pottstown. Exactly 10 seconds to go in the half.
It seems like a lot of the pauses happen at the exact second mark. Or the exact... Yeah.
Yeah, right. The last three have. The last three stoppages of time have come at exactly an even second. It was 43 seconds earlier, and the Firebirds killed 33 of them. So here's Tomasetti, and it's a turnover. And it was a foul called.
One more.
And the foul called against Pottstown. It would have been out of bounds on them if it wasn't. Now 9.5 seconds to go. Mark Tomasetti will go to the line to shoot two. 17 fouls this half. Combined for both teams, 9 for Pottstown, 8 for Holy Ghost. So Tomasetti will wait back at the 3-point line for his foul shots to be ready. 9.5 seconds to go in the first half. And Tomasetti makes them both, it makes it a 6-point game. Right now it sits at 22-18. Tomasetti up. It's good. So Tomasetti makes his first of the one-on-one attempts. That makes it a 23-18 lead for Holy Ghost. Tomasetti dribbles once. Now he'll hold it. It's up. And it is good. Tomasetti makes them both. Here's Pottstown on the far side. Dribbling it up. It's Abdul Jackson. Jackson running the clock down. 3 seconds. 2 seconds. He needs to shoot. Jackson up. And no good.
Oh, rolls out.
Abdul Jackson, the clip-hanging layup off the front edge of the rim. It does not fall. 24-18. Holy Ghost Prep will be your halftime score. 16 down. 16 to go from the Chapman Arena. And we'll be back in 10.
Hey, now it's on. All right. Max and Ben are watching the broadcast.
Yeah. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the second half action at the Chapman Arena with the Firebirds leading 24-18.
So Fire.
24-18 Firebirds lead after 16 minutes of play. 16 more coming up as the both teams put their starters out on the court.
Firebirds are sending out their starting lineup, as Caden said. Tomasetti, McDermott, Varella, Hendrix, and Boutillier to face off against Pottstown in the second half.
So the Firebird in the action-packed student section at the moment. Again, 24-18, your score. Holy Ghost Prep on top after 16 minutes of play. The Firebirds want to answer on a hot streak.
Holy 5-for-8.
Pottstown will inbound from out front of the broadcast booth. Jarrell Young dumps it off to Julian Beasley. Beasley, what a move. Those are the top of the key. It's a three. It's no good.
Kind of
that was Ty Elliott Moore who took the triple.
I'm shooting 62.5%.
Oh, my God. And now here's the three from Tomasetti. It's no good. Rebounded out, and that was Hendrix who went out of bounds with it. 7:38 to play in the third quarter. Pottstown takes over from underneath their own net. So it was an extremely high-scoring first half in the JV game. And it's been a tale of two halves on both sides, because the Firebirds didn't have that high of scoring in the first half, and so did really the Pottstown didn't either. Here's a three from the corner, and he knocks it down. Ty Elliott Moore has been on fire for Pottstown, and it's now 24-21.
I believe
here is Varella.
I believe Moore would be their highest scorer, I believe, right?
Has to be. Bro, those are the corner. It's a three. It's off the front of the rim and no good. The Firebirds can't convert. Here comes Pottstown again. The cutback lays it up, and it's a foul. And it's a charging foul against Pottstown. Holy Ghost Prep takes over from underneath their own net. Tomasetti, it appears, will inbound to Adrien Varella. 7:05 to play in the third quarter. 24-21, Holy Ghost. Varella lofts it down. Back to the corner. Brendan Boutillier. It's an easy two. Boutillier up and good for two as a 5-point lead for Holy Ghost.
Can I take the next offensive drive?
And it's a travel called against Pottstown. The Firebirds take over. And some words after the play between Ty Elliott Moore and Mark Tomasetti.
Inbound seems to be coming in from Tomasetti, and Varella is the most likely recipient. Varella driving up left side, cuts back around, out to the corner to McDermott, and Boutillier comes down hard. No foul called. Well, Pottstown goes on a counter drive.
That was Jarrell Young who went charging towards the net, laid up a 2-point layup. It was no good, but goes to the line to shoot two after the foul.
This is going to be Jarrell Young shooting these, the forward. The junior forward.
So Varella called for the foul. And said it's second of the game, and Jarrell Young makes his first.
Young going for his second free throw. And it's off the front rim. Boutillier recovers, fires over to Hendrix, right side. Hendrix stops, chills, over to Varella, over the key. Varella shoots left side, left wing, over to Tomasetti. Tomasetti drives, back corner, Varella goes over the middle to Boutillier, gets it to Hendrix's hands, layup, and it is good. It's a 28-22 ball game on the short mid-range for me and Hendrix.
Hendrix has been on fire the second half, struggled late in the first, but has come back to his own. It's now 28-22 HGP. 6 minutes to go in this third quarter. And the ball will go off of Holy Ghost and stay with Pottstown in their offensive zone. It's Abdul Jackson who will inbound, and he has multiple options, including another Jackson. And it's Sadiq Jackson. Abdul Jackson dumps it off, and this 2-point shot is no good. That was Julian Beasley who took it. Beasley gets his own rebound, and he'd be fouled by Varella.
Interestingly enough, while I haven't gotten any playing time, there are two freshmen on this Pottstown varsity roster.
and it was actually not a foul, but it was a real jump ball, and the ball belongs to Holy Ghost. As Tomasetti coming across half court. Tomasetti inching his way. Fires to center. It's up, and it's no good.
Varella puts it
yes,
back down for two.
Adrien Varella gets his own rebound and nails it. 30-22, Holy Ghost. They're starting to run away with it. Can they control the lead? 5.5 to play in the third quarter. Here is Pottstown on the attack. Abdul Jackson dumps it off, going back and forth. Tic-tac-toe, three, it's good.
Wow. That was
Ty Elliott Moore.
That was a perfecto right there. Middle of the rim. Yeah. Flawless off the hands. That was incredible.
Ty Elliott Moore with a dagger, and that cuts the lead down to 5. 30-25. Hendrix for two, it's
Ian
good.
Hendrix.
32-25, Holy Ghost. 3 minutes gone in the second half. 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. 8:13 to go in this half.
We should rename the MVP to the Ball So Hard Award.
Oh, yeah, that's actually not a bad idea. So Pottstown with an easy two. They lead back down to 5. There is HGP, McDermott. Running around the top of the key. McDermott back up to Tomasetti. Tomasetti, Sutter step. Back up to the top to Boutillier. Boutillier up, and it is no good. Rebounded by Pottstown in the paint. They take it back out. Here is Abdul Jackson. Jackson, Sutter steps. Splits the defenders, he's fouled. And Abdul Jackson goes to the line to shoot two. So 32-27, Holy Ghost on top.
Seamus for McDermott, his first and second.
McDermott called with his first foul of the game. Two fouls for Holy Ghost in these first 3.5 minutes of the third quarter. A chance to make it a one-shot game for Abdul Jackson. He needs to make them both. And he makes his first.
32-28. For your substitution, Noah McDermott.
So Noah McDermott subs on, and it's Tomasetti coming off. Abdul Jackson at the line to shoot his second. He made his first, and he makes his second.
And it's
Abdul
a one possession game once again. I mean, Pottstown's coming back in a quick fashion.
It's the same thing against Ben Salem on Thursday night. The Firebirds cannot hold that big of a lead. From the corner, it's Hendrix to Varella. Varella was open. Varella lost it, and he's fouled. Ty Elliott Moore called for the foul against Varella. And Elliott Moore, the leading scorer for Pottstown today, he has been on fire. And now the inbound pass goes haywire, but it's picked up by Varella. Varella charging on in, and his shot was may have been blocked. And here is Pottstown. It's Abdul Jackson. Jackson cutting through, dumps it off, and Varella missed the block. Was it an and one play? It is. Rasheen Bostic makes the layup, and he goes to the line and tie the game.
This is a shot to take the lead for Pottstown. I mean, tie it up for Pottstown.
Yeah.
My bad. So
Varella is his third foul of the game, getting in some foul trouble late. 32-31, Holy Ghost. The foul shot is missed. It's rebounded by HGP. Now lost it. Here comes the fire. Here is Pottstown again. It's up and good. And is that an and one?
Ian Hendrix is down and hurt, walking off to the sideline.
Yeah, Hendrix is...
He's limping. Yeah, he Jacoby's going to look at this.
So the layup was good for Pottstown. They have their first lead in a long time. 33-32. Hendrix not going directly to the medical table.
Well, and now he
halfway
is.
Halfway through exactly this third quarter, they're going to have a team meeting. Hendrix sits down, but not on the medical table. That might be a good sign. 33-32. It's Pottstown in the lead for the first time in a while. So coming out of the timeout, 4 minutes to go in the third quarter, 33-32, Pottstown on top. The Trojans on a high-scoring run. They've outscored Holy Ghost 10-2 over the last 2 minutes. Varella from the three-point line charges into the paint, and he scores.
Yeah.
Nice!
Varella, Adrien, ace Varella, makes it 34-33 in favor of the Firebirds. Now it's a jump ball. It's a three. Ty Elliott.
Oh, no.
Where's Jarrell Young? And Jarrell Young nails another triple. It's 36-34 in favor of the Pottstown Trojans. Here is Noah McDermott. McDermott back out to the top to his brother, Seamus. Noah back to Seamus. Now it's Noah with the ball. Noah dumps it off in the paint. It's up and no good. As Boutillier couldn't finish it. Here comes Abdul Jackson. Jackson goes tumbling down the court. And it will stay with Pottstown. Seamus McDermott called for a second foul of the game. 36-34 in favor of Pottstown. Opportunity to go up by two scores. It'll be our largest lead of the game. 3:14 to go in the third quarter. Here's a pass right into the paint, and it's no good. Rebound, foul. Jarrell Young, who just hit a three, gets fouled on the layup attempt, and he goes to the line to shoot two. And Noah McDermott getting called for a second foul. Jarrell Young's first of his two, and it's no good. So the best he can do is make it a three-point game. The Firebirds have not attempted that many threes yet today, so a three-point game may hang on for a little while. The second foul shot is up, and that one's no good. And for the second time today, Pottstown has missed both free throws. Here's Varella. Varella from the written emblem. Varella, stutter step, spin move, back up to the corner. It's a three. It's a long one. It's good!
Colin! Lucas!
Colin, Lucas from the corner, and it's a Firebird lead, 37-36. Here comes Pottstown. Ty Elliott Moore. Votes went off on the side of the backboard. Back onto the top of the key. It was open for three. He decided not to take it. It was Jarrell Young. Young pressure to the corner. It's a travel. A travel called on Jarrell Young. The Firebirds take over from the corner. It's Dasani, McNeely, and Ace Varella. Ace Varella getting the ball as you can't do that. Chance rained down in the Chapman Arena. Varella across half court. Varella with a dump off pass to McDermott. McDermott looking for a way in. He's going to find one. McDermott back to the corner to Varella. Varella had a three-point attempt. He decided not to go for it. Varella to the corner. Looking for McDermott. And McDermott is fouled. 2:24 to go in the third quarter. It's a 37-36 Firebirds lead. Seamus McDermott, an opportunity to add on to that.
Everyone in the student section doing the magic hands, getting ready for a made free throw.
And Seamus McDermott misses and the no. first. So McDermott 0-for-1 from the line to start. We'll have one more. A chance to make it a 2-point game with 2:24 to go in the third quarter. And the second one is
and
good.
And it works.
Seamus McDermott goes 1-for-2 at the line thanks to the magic hands in the student section.
The magic hands always work at least once.
Right. Julian Beasley lays it up and in. And that was Beasley going to Ty Elliott Moore who laid it up and in.
This game is super close right now.
Yeah, we're tied up at 38. We're going to have another dramatic finish. The Firebirds only lost by 4 against Mensalem. Looking to turn this game around. Varella drops it off. And that was Noah McDermott who couldn't corral the pass. McDermott has a clear foul. That was Ty Elliott Moore fouling Colin Lucas in a great call right in front of the written emblem.
Again, it stopped exactly at 2 minutes.
Yeah. So as you said, exactly 2 minutes to go in this third quarter. Abdul Jackson subs on in favor of Ty Elliott Moore. Elliott Moore has been the sharpshooter all day for the Trojans. Here is Noah McDermott. McDermott dumps it off to Colin Ty. Ty, back to McDermott for three. It's good!
What a
Noah
shot from
McDermott.
McDermott
nails the three. It's 41-38. A minute 44 to go in the third.
I'll take next drive.
All right. Here's Pottstown from the top. It's DeMarc Lyons getting his name called for the first time today. It's a three. It's a long one. High arc error is no good. Firebirds rebound.
Lucas hands it off to Noah McDermott. Drives right side. Fires over the left wing to Varella. Back to McDermott. Corner. Three ball off brim. And that's going to be taken back by Pottstown.
It was rebounded by Jarrell Young, dumps it off to Abdul Jackson. Jackson for three. It's good.
Oh.
Pottstown has tied the game at 41. A minute, 7 seconds to play in the third period. 41-41 tie. It's going to be a good game no matter who wins. Noah McDermott to the corner. It's a three. It's no good.
Oh.
And that was Colin Lucas, who couldn't corral it. And over and back penalty is called against Pottstown. It was Jarrell Young who has expressed his displeasure with the referees all day today. Mostly unwarranted, as Jackson went over to Jarrell Young, and the Firebirds take over at half court. Adrien Varella with the ball behind half court. Varella needs to hustle up and get over. He will. He'll take his time doing so. 43 seconds to go. Varella dumps it off to Seamus McDermott. McDermott back to Noah McDermott. Noah McDermott to Varella, back to Seamus McDermott. Seamus McDermott looking for his brother. He finds him again to Noah. Noah McDermott. Back to Seamus. 24 seconds. It's Varella. It's knocked away, and the ball came flying towards the scorer's table. And it was ruled out on Pottstown. So it's Seamus McDermott with the ball, who will inbound right in front of the broadcast booth. Julian Beasley in coverage. Is Adrien Varella. I said Aiden. The streak is over.
How unfortunate.
Adrien Varella across half court. 13 seconds to play. It's Seamus McDermott. It's Colin Lucas. Lucas throws to the corner. Now it's McDermott. Picks it up. McDermott finds Varella for three. Varella, no good. And Dasani McNeely can't put it away. 24 minutes down, 8 minutes to go, and it'll be a pivotal 8 minutes for either team. 41 points for the Firebirds, 41 points for the Trojans, and it's going to come down to the home stretch. Again, your score. So Pottstown inbound from their side of half court. Here's Abdul Jackson. Jackson going around. Jackson dumps it off. It's the Deke Jackson now. Jackson to Jackson. Back to the corner. It's no good. It was a three from Julian Beasley. And the Firebirds take over with Noah McDermott, the 5'9 senior.
That's unfortunately not his third team's fifth.
McDermott inbounds to Adrien Ace Varella. Varella comes across half court. Varella will inbounds to McNeely. McNeely, and he is fouled. That's Jarrell Young getting called for yet another foul. And we have the substitution. As Brendan Boutillier and Mark Tomasetti both come on. Dasani McNeely and Noah McDermott both comes off. Jarrell Young with his fourth foul, the sixth of the half against Pottstown. Only three of this half for Holy Ghost. Mark Tomasetti inches his way across, dumps it off for McDermott. McDermott back to Adrien Varella. Varella, spin move underneath the Brendan Boutillier. Brendan Boutillier, an easy two-pointer. It's 43-41. Abdul Jackson with the ball along the far side. Jackson, spin move, up and good. And a travel. No basket, a travel called against number 5, Abdul Jackson. And more, you can do that chance coming down. It was a timeout called, it was.
That's one of my favorite chants.
It has to be, yeah, that's an all-time classic. Pottstown calls timeout. In this fourth quarter, the Firebirds have taken a 2-0 run. It's 43-41, Holy Ghost. 58 seconds. So 7:02 to go in this in regulation time. 43-41, Holy Ghost Prep on top, and they will have possession with Varella. Adrien Varella. Inbounds back to Colin Lucas. Lucas back to Mark Tomasetti. Tomasetti up across half court. Tomasetti stutter steps. Over to the sideline for Adrien Varella. Varella back on the top, is intercepted and turned over. And it was Abdul Jackson who couldn't hang on to it for the Trojans. So here come the Trojans with Abdul Jackson taking it up as the ball was ruled out on the Firebirds. Jackson, back up to the top. It's a long two, and it's no good. Rebound, gets his own rebound, it's Sadiq Jackson. The second attempt doesn't fall, and he's fouled. Rasheen Bostic gets his own rebound and finishes the job, and he'll go to the line to shoot one. Rasheen Bostic will get Pottstown the lead. He does. Rasheen Bostic makes it 44-43 with 6:27 to go in regulation. Here comes Mark Tomasetti. Tomasetti has another step. Makes a move, and he's blocked. Rebound by Boutillier, and Boutillier's fouled underneath the hoop. So Brendan Boutillier goes to the line to shoot two for the Firebirds. Boutillier will shoot 1-1. Firebirds down by one with 6:19 to go in regulation. Boutillier's first one is up, and it's no good. Rebounded by Pottstown. Here is Pottstown, dumps it off. A three-point attempt is turned away by Elliot Moore, and it's a foul. And a foul will most likely go against Colin Lucas, as Elliot Moore made a move in towards the net. Elliot Moore at the line to shoot two for Pottstown, looking to make it a three-point game. Elliot Moore dribbles three times. Shot. Good. 45-43 in favor of Pottstown. 6:11 to go in regulation. Can Pottstown take a three-point lead? They will not. And the ball is out, and it belongs to Holy Ghost. So the Firebirds being outscored by 4 over the last 60 seconds. The Rasheen Bostic called for the Pottstown foul. His second foul. And the Trojans, 8th of the half. The Firebirds have 7 of the, in this half by themselves. Brendan Boutillier goes to the line to shoot 2. It's 45-43 in favor of Pottstown. 6 minutes and 6 seconds to play. And Boutillier backs off, goes out to the three-point line. Boutillier gets the one bounce pass. Boutillier's first one is off and no good. And the Firebirds can't convert on foul shots. Boutillier gets his own rebound and can't finish. Varella shot Varella got the rebound off the missed foul shot. And now turnover. Mark Tomasetti up across half court. Tomasetti splitting the two defenders. Tomasetti makes the man miss. Back up to the corner. It's a three, and it is no good. Colin Lucas couldn't finish the three. Here is Abdul Jackson across half court. Jackson dribbling a few times. Jackson splits the defenders again. Back up to the corner. It was an open three. Look for Sadiq Jackson. Doesn't take it. Takes the two. It's good. Sadiq Jackson nails the two. It's 47-43 in favor of Pottstown. They're starting to run away with it. The Firebirds need to do something. Tomasetti, and he's blocked. Timeout was called by Holy Ghost before the block. So Sadiq Jackson absolutely pummeled Tomasetti coming towards the net, but there's no call because of the timeout. So 47-43 in favor of Pottstown. Six straight points in the last minute and 45. What can the Firebirds do to respond? So far, nothing. And with 5:21 to go in the fourth, the Firebirds trail by four. .5:21 to go in regulation. 47-43, Pottstown on top. What can the Firebirds do to make a comeback? So here is this quick inbound to Mark Tomasetti. Tomasetti with the ball at the three-point line. They send Varella in. A dump off to McDermott. Back to Tomasetti. Tomasetti finds Varella under the hoop. Varella is fouled. The layup is no good, but Varella goes to the line to shoot two. And Ace Varella looking to cut the lead in half. And the first foul shot for Varella is up and good. So it's a one-score game. Varella at the foul line to shoot his second. 47-44, Pottstown on top. Varella's second one is good, and Adrien Varella makes two in a row. The Firebirds had foul shot struggles in their loss against Bensalem. They've had some foul shot struggles here late, but Varella looking to bring them back on track. Here's a thread the needle pass. McNeely, jump ball. Who gets it? And it's Pottstown that gets it. But Dasani McNeely with great effort on the ground. Here's the inbound coming in from Jarrell Young. Young out to the corner. Looking for Sadiq Jackson. Jackson underneath the rim. He doesn't get there. Inbounded by Colin Lucas. Here is Mark Tomasetti. Tomasetti floats one out. Gets his own pass back. Tomasetti. He's being double teamed. To the corner. It's a three. It's good! Seamus McDermott. A banger of a three. It's 48-47 in favor of the Firebirds. They have come out firing. Oh, it's blocked! What a block! What a block out in front for the Firebirds. He gets his own rebound. It's good. Sadiq Jackson nails the two. It's a 49-48 lead in favor of Pottstown. And this game is going to come down to the wire. Mark Tomasetti back out to the top. Seamus McDermott back to Tomasetti. Tomasetti and McDermott. And they're playing hot potato. Out to Varella. Varella back to Tomasetti. Tomasetti to McNeely. McNeely back out to Mr. McDermott. He doesn't get it. Rebound by Ace, and he couldn't finish. And a foul under the rim. And the foul looks like it'll be going against Holy Ghost. So 49-48 in favor of Pottstown. 3:56 to go in regulation. Colin Lucas with his third foul of the game, the eighth for the Firebirds. And the eighth of the half of the Firebirds. Yeah, really, if you're looking at who has the ball last, it's the same thing with Ben Salem. Who has the ball? Yeah. So the 1-1 attempt is missed on the first shot. And was that another foul? It was. So Rasheen Bostic called for the foul against Pottstown, and now Holy Ghost with a chance to take the lead. 3:56 to go in regulation. It's Ty Elliott Moore having a conversation with the referee. Alright. Colin Lucas goes to the line. It should be in 1-1. Oh, it's technical. Oh, it's not. Oh, that's right. My bad. Yeah, I got confused with the formation they had. So Lucas makes the first one. It's a tie game at 49. 3:56 to go. And the second one is up and no good off the front of the rim. Here comes Pottstown. It's Abdul Jackson. Jackson going back to the corner to tie Elliott Moore. Elliott Moore is blocked. Adrien Ace Varella with a shut the door block. And now it's a quick turnover from Tomasetti. Here is Sadiq Jackson. Jackson, and that's a charging foul. Sadiq Jackson called for the charging foul, and once again, Pottstown cannot believe it. Adrien Varella with a one bounce inbound to Mark Tomasetti. Tomasetti takes his time bringing it across half court. 3.5 to play in regulation. Tomasetti back out to McDermott. McDermott to Varella. Varella. Out to the corner. It's Tomasetti. Tomasetti making a move. Back out to the side. That's easy, too. It does not go. It does not go. It was Seamus McDermott who could not finish. And Colin Lucas foul. Colin Lucas gets called for the foul. And Sadiq Jackson going to the line to shoot two for Pottstown. 3:19 to go in regulation. 49-49 draw at the moment. The first foul shot is up and no good. And it's a 1-1. Rebound Jackson, no good. Gets his own rebound again. He goes down. Fireball. And Jackson a little slow to get up. Helped up by Seamus McDermott. So it's Varella and Tomasetti who stay back. And Varella inbounds to Tomasetti. Varella has to hustle up, and he will. Adrien Varella from the top. Varella slicing in. Sirtu, it's no good. Rasheen Bostic dumps it off to Abdul Jackson. 2:57 to go in regulation. Abdul Jackson with the ball. Jackson dribbling up on the far side. Jackson charging in. It's good. And one for Abdul Jackson. Pottstown has taken a 51-49 lead, and they have a chance to make it 52. Both teams now at 10 fouls and a half. 2:46 to play in the fourth quarter. And the one and only foul shot is up and good. 52-49 in favor of Pottstown. The Pottstown Trojans will do a full court press. Here is Tomasetti. Tomasetti comes flying up. Mark Tomasetti cuts to the paint. Lays up for two. It's no good. Tipped around. Rebounded by Pottstown. Abdul Jackson takes it out. Jackson up across half court. Jackson dumps up to Sadiq Jackson. And he turns it over. McDermott to Varella. And Varella is fouled. Ace Varella should be shooting two. 2:24 to go in regulation. 52-49 in favor of Pottstown. Varella to shoot two. We can make it a 1-point game. Varella dribbles twice at the line. His first shot is up and good. The first foul shot rattles around the Firebirds at half a hundred. 52-50 in favor of Pottstown. And back-to-back excellent games for the Firebirds varsity offense. Varella can make this. If he makes this, he can make it a one-point game. It's up. It's good. And Varella has made four clutch foul shots for the Firebirds. 52-51 in favor of Pottstown. The Firebirds just need one big play, and they can get it at any time. It's Seamus McDermott. Who wants it more? The Firebirds or the Trojans? McDermott forcing out Abdul Jackson. Jackson backing up at half court. Over to the Firebird emblem. Jackson holding on to it. 2 minutes to go. Jackson charging in. Jackson up. And foul, but no basket. So 52-51, the Firebirds trail. Pottstown with an opportunity to make it a three-point game again. And it's Abdul Jackson going line to shoot two with a minute 57 to play. Yeah, and the first one is no good from Abdul Jackson. Pottstown has missed a set of two free throws twice today. If they do it again, we all get 12 free chicken Chick-fil-A nuggets. And the second one, he missed it again. And Dasani McNeely inbounds to Noah McDermott. McDermott brings it up around. McDermott, a one bounce pass to the corner to McNeely. McNeely charging in. McNeely for two, it's good. The Firebirds had the lead, 53-52. Holy Ghost Pep on top. A minute 39 to play in regulation. Here is Pottstown up across half court. Both teams in the bonus on fouls. A foul could be deadly. McNeely is called for one.
Are you serious?
No. No basket. But Dasani McNeely is called for the foul. And Sadiq Jackson goes to the line to shoot two for Pottstown. Jackson up. Good. Pottstown has tied the game at 53. A minute 29 to play in regulation. Again, there is no shot clock. So this could come down to two possessions. And who has the last one? The second foul shot spins and rattles in. Adrien Varella with the Firebirds down by one. Takes it up across the written emblem from the three-point line. Varella inbound to Dasani McNeely. It's good! Dasani McNeely with four clutch points. The Firebirds on top, 55-54, a minute 12 to go in the fourth quarter. Here is Abdul Jackson. Jackson looking to make a move in. Jackson spins, no foul, it's good. The Trojans have a one-point lead, 56-55. Here is Varella, Varella from the three-point line. He dumps it off. McDermott, that's Noah McDermott. And here to Varella. Varella pulls off the three. Varella to the corner. Wide open was McNeely, did not shoot it. McNeely back over to Noah McDermott. 41 seconds to play. McDermott back to the other McDermott and Seamus. And Seamus McDermott to Noah McDermott. Noah McDermott finds the open man, and it's a foul in the paint. Not sure who it's on, but Colin Lucas will go to the line to shoot two. And it's a pushing foul. Number two, Julian Baisley called for his second foul. The Firebirds will have a chance to take the lead. And a timeout called by what appears to be caught. And Pottstown calls timeout. 33 seconds exactly. That's how much time is left in regulation. 56-55 in favor of Pottstown. It is Colin Lucas with the opportunity to tie the game and give the Firebirds the lead. Jack, what a game it has been. The back-to-back great games, as we mentioned before. Ben Salem, they fell by four. They fell apart. The Firebird defense fell apart here late, and their offense just couldn't connect. But it has been the exact opposite. The Firebirds coming up with multiple good defensive plays late, and Dasani McNeely, two clutch deuces to give the Firebirds the one-point lead, give the Firebirds back within one. both teams in the bonus. Holy Ghost Prep at 11 fouls, although the scoreboard says 10. I believe it's 11. And the Pottstown Cougars. Or sorry, the Pottstown. Why do I? I don't know why. I don't know why. And the Pottstown Trojans sitting at 10. I'm serious. Don't say anything. So Colin Lucas at the line. 33 seconds to play. The pressure is on Lucas. 56-55 in favor of Pottstown. His first one's up and no good. Lucas has one more to tie the game. 33 seconds to play. The Firebirds down by one. Colin Lucas makes it. Tie game. Colin Lucas has tied it. Here comes Pottstown on the offensive. Abdul Jackson holding on to it. Pottstown can take the last shot if they want. 20 seconds to play. There's no shot clock. They can hold on to it for as long as they can. Abdul Jackson with space. McNeely giving him room. Jackson inching his way up. 7 seconds, 6 seconds, 5 seconds. Abdul Jackson charging in. Jackson. Blocked. Rebound. It's good. It's good. Pottstown has won it at the buzzer. Adrien Varella blocked it at the last second. A Hail Mary shot went up. It bounced off the top of the backboard and fell through. Pottstown has won 58-56. What a finish. That has to be a heartbreaker for Firebird fans. But an exciting and dramatic win for Pottstown. 58-56, the Pottstown Trojans have defeated the Holy Ghost Prep Firebirds. Lansdale Catholic comes to town Thursday night, but for the moment, pain and heartbreak for the Firebirds. We'll be back with a post-game show and interviews after this heartbreaking loss for HGP. Again, your final score. All right, hello everyone, and welcome back to the Chapman Arena and the Firebird Fieldhouse at Holy Ghost Prep, where we have a pained Firebird fandom as the Firebirds fall 58-56 in dramatic fashion on a last millisecond buzzer beater. So we're going to have a post-game interview. It could not happen today, but we do have some positives, with the player of the game being Dasani McNeely. Two clutch two-point shots to bring the Firebirds back within one in multiple different points of the game, then giving them one to take the lead, but it just wasn't enough. So the Firebirds fall 58-56. They are now 1-4. However, the JV team, with a dominant win, also over Pottstown, and in that game, Zach Sharlin shined, as well as almost everyone else on that roster. Every starter and half the bench scored a point. And considering the bench was full, that has... It was certainly a very big impact on the fan mentality and especially the players' mentality. So, anything you want to add to that, Jack?
I mean, just rough varsity game. JV showed definitely some promise for the rest of the season. We just got to go back out. I think Lansdowne on Thursday.
Yeah, and speaking of Lansdowne on Thursday, the Firebirds had a very promising schedule coming up after Unionville on the, or sorry, after Lansdowne Catholic on the 15th, Quakertown on the 17th, Lower Moreland on the 19th, and Bristol on the 23rd, before the Jack Schott Memorial Christmas Tournament on the 28th and 29th between Harry S. Truman, William Tennant, and the Chamonix. So again, your player of the game for Holy Ghost Prep Firebirds, Dasani McNeely, for JV, Zach Sharlin. Again, the final score 58-56 in favor of Pottstown in the varsity game, and a buzzer beater final score. So, as we said, a heartbreaking loss, but the Firebirds will rebound against Lansdowne Catholic on Thursday night. So with that, I'm...
Four! Holy Ghost Prep ties it up!
Holy Ghost is on the move.
Yeah, Firebirds had a lot of momentum.
Right from the jump for the Firebirds, it looked really good.